This study stemmed from a larger project looking at the detection of misinformation. One of the characteristics commonly found in false news is that they are written using clickbait to lure users into engaging with content. So as we start engaging with this literature, we realized there were a lot of mixed findings. On one hand, some studies indicate clear user preference for clickbait. But on the other hand, other studies suggest clickbait is not more effective than non-clickbait. So in this study, we wondered, why is this the case? Why the mixed findings? And there's a few possible reasons. The first one is the different operationalizations of clickbait across studies. For example, some studies define clickbait as the use of questions, but others as the use of lists. So it is possible that some clickbait characteristics are more effective than others. Yet a second possibility has to do with the different methodological approaches. It is possible that the null results from experimental studies is due to the low external validity of the method. But it is also possible that the engagement captured through computational methods do not represent engagement with clickbait per se, but third variables embedded in the assumptions of each clickbait detector. While some computational models are trained with data labeled by human coders, other models utilize source assumptions. Likewise, some detectors are built using traditional machine learning, while others utilize more complex deep learning models. So we explored these possibilities via three studies. And in the first study, participants were asked to engage with seven different clickbait headlines and a non-clickbait headline. And we scraped headlines by following the following procedure. First, we scraped headlines from reliable and unreliable sources. We coded them computationally to determine the clickbait characteristic. And we passed the headlines by three highly accurate clickbait detectors. And we only used headlines that were classified as clickbait by the three classifiers. So how did the interaction look like for participants? For each headline, participants had the option to click on read more if they would be likely to read the article farther, or share if they would be likely to share the article with their network of friends. And the same interaction was completed for the seven clickbait and non-clickbait headlines. We found that non-clickbait received significantly more reads than five of the clickbait characteristics and the same as the other three. Non-clickbait was also perceived as more credible and less deceptive and more curiosity arousing. But we utilized headlines scraped from online sources in the interest of ecological validity. But it resulted in headlines pertaining to different topics and associated with different articles, creating a content confound when comparing the various types of headlines. So we conducted study number two. And here we selected only one headline and a trained journalist systematically varied the headline to contain only one of the clickbait characteristics. And again, no significant differences. So the null findings of study two suggest two possibilities. One, clickbait is not as clickbaity as we think, or the higher engagement of clickbait headlines found in computational analysis might represent third variables attributable to the assumptions of each clickbait detector. So we run a third study. Once again, we scraped headlines from reliable and non-reliable sources, but this time we linked them to actual shared data. We also added another classifier, which resulted in a 2x2 design. And what did we find? We find that three of the four classifiers suggest that users engage more with headlines using demonstrative adjectives, WH words, and lists. So at least in a real-world scenario, these three characteristics seem to generate better results than non-clickbait. But these findings should be taken with caution. The four classifiers agreed on the classification only 47% of the times. Of the 370 headlines, 139 were classified by the four as clickbait and 36 as non-clickbait. So overall, our findings suggest that determining whether a headline is clickbait or not is quite complex. It does not simply depend on a few key linguistic characteristics. It also depends on the nature of the automated classifier used to distinguish clickbait from non-clickbait. The low agreement among classifiers also raised fundamental doubts about the reliability of computational clickbait detectors. This suggests that the success of future detectors should be analyzed beyond their individual performance, with a few suggestions outlined in our paper. Thank you.